Warriors, welcome. Your questions matter. You're listening to the Ask the Anxiety Guy show.
This podcast episode is brought to you by the End the Anxiety Program, a downloadable CBT-based program created by the Anxiety Guy himself to help heal your emotional distress and put anxiety behind you once and for all. Visit www.anxietyexit.com to learn more today.
Warriors, welcome to episode number 170 of the Anxiety Guy podcast. This is the hashtag Ask the Anxiety Guy show, where you ask the questions related to anxiety, emotional distress, life challenges, and I do my best to answer those with as much detail and value as I can. Warriors, let's jump into the show right away, shall we? Jill Anderson asks a very crucial question today related to parenting and childhood. She's asking, Dennis, what's the best way to guarantee that your child won't get anxiety the same way the parent has? What an interesting question. And I mean, let's be honest, right? As a parent who is or has suffered from emotional distress consistently, we've all asked this question, haven't we? Is our child going to become us? Are they going to have the same consistent emotional states, the same ways of thinking and fearing the world? Are they going to misinterpret everything the way I do? Well, let's jump into this right now. Firstly, I'm a little bit concerned, Jill, because of the fact that you're using the word guarantee in your question, which tells me where the child will most likely get her anxiety from if she does. Because you cannot guarantee anything in today's world. And you can learn to be okay with that. All right? So first and foremost, you have to understand, as a parent, you personally are scared of losing control of things you have little control over. You don't want to raise your child that way, because the world that is uncertain, when there's a balance between certainty and uncertainty, control and giving up control, that's where the magic lies. We are meant to live a spontaneous and adventurous and mysterious life to some extent. So please, eliminate that word. There is no guarantee. Now, your child will pick up on your every action and mimic you in every way. Remember that. I mean, you've got some really good pressure here, right? You've got good pressure here. You've got pressure and drive and motivation to pay attention, which is something that so many parents today do not do. For God's sakes, if you're not going to embrace a world of uncertainty and unknown and step into that world consistently and work on you to master you, do it for your child, right? Create self-awareness. Create this consistent awareness of, what am I thinking? Because energetically, that child is picking up on your thinking, on your intentions, on your beliefs, on your actions, everything. So you want to make sure that first and foremost, you become more self-aware of what the heck you're doing, what you're thinking, how you're reacting, all of those things. And we must find a balance between discipline and fun. You'll notice that anxiety sufferers have no fun in their lives anymore. Fun is right out the door. What the heck was fun? Fun was when I look back on my high school days and my college days. Oh my God, I was so carefree. Oh, I had so much fun with those friends and those environments and those situations. Oh, I wish I could be that person again. Does that sound like you? Right? So the fun is basically out the door because the brain's filter system is geared towards threats. It's always at the moment looking for the next threat, which keeps your body in a very tense state. And when you're tense, trust me, I mean, any sensation is misinterpreted, right? Anything on the outside, any criticism from someone is seen as do or die. So, parents, you have to find a balance between discipline and fun. The more anxious you are, the more you're gonna want to control the child and each and everything that they do. Poor child. Kids are supposed to have fun. Let them have fun. And in fact, your job is to learn from those kids. You gotta learn from your child. Stop trying to control every single aspect of that child's life. Now, what you also want to make sure you do is, first of all, understand that children want to be accepted, acknowledged, and understood. So much of the parent's anxiety is based around a childhood where they felt misunderstood. Think about it for a moment. I'll give you a second. Did you feel misunderstood as a child? Were you doing your best trying to meet the needs that you had, but they weren't getting met? You were misunderstood. Now, what's one of the best ways to help a child feel understood? Best way is to subtly mirror that child, mirror them. Do you know the kind of rapport and bond you're going to build with your child? They're going to feel understood and accepted if you mirror, say, their body language. You know, they're jumping up and down like a monkey. Go ahead, jump up and down like a monkey. You know, they're hunched over, you hunch over, right? They start scratching their chin, you scratch your chin. Watch what unconsciously starts to happen. The child's nervous system will begin to adopt what you're doing. It will feel accepted in this world. In a world where so much of everyday life, we are being misunderstood. We are in a rat race. We don't even have time to think. We are constantly in reactive mode. We don't want the child to grow up this way and feel like the world is constantly misunderstanding them. You also must teach yourself first and then your child how to think next. Thinking means to become aware of facts. Thinking means to analyze, to rationalize, to promote logic, to strengthen rational ideas, to learn from past failures, and to know where you're going. The child must have these strengths in their arsenal. They must be a good thinker. And I'll tell you the truth, in today's world, it's rare that people spend more than 5 times a year thinking. Think about that for a second, right? On average, it's about 2. 2 times a year you think. Oh, Dennis, that's crazy. I think all the time. No, you're not thinking. You're remembering, as Richard Bandler puts it. And you're reacting, and you're impulsive, and you're in default mode. You are not taking deliberate action to think and analyze through something. Don't let your child fall into this trap. The other thing is get them reading more books that aren't so emotionally stimulating, but intellectually stimulating. I mean, you know, Archie comics are great, all right? They're great and they're entertaining, but at some point, the child, again, needs to learn a bunch of different skill sets that they don't learn in school. The way they're going to do that is through you and through books. So those skill sets are the things that I just mentioned, okay? Like a vision. You know, schools don't teach you to create a vision for yourself, right? They teach you to stay in the rat race, right? Get a good job, get educated, right? Work for a good company, raise a family, die. That's pretty much it. And this is key, this step, and you gotta take this step seriously, make hydration a habit. Not just for the child, but for you as well. The human brain is made up of 75% water, and dehydration slows down circulation, which lowers blood flow, which means less oxygen traveling to the brain. What do you think is going to happen? Of course he's going to be impulsive. I'm going to suggest that you and your child drink one glass of water upon waking, and two glasses per meal, which is gonna benefit your mental, emotional, and physical states. So, so, so important. Don't take it lightly. I mean, if you're watching this on YouTube, check this out. I got that I bring this thing everywhere, right? And so, I leave you with the quote of the day. Are you treating yourself the same way others treated you during childhood? Take these words, brainstorm them, take time to analyze them, and come up with an answer. My friends, share this podcast episode with a parent in need. I love you all so very much. You are more than anxiety. See you soon.
Warriors, remember, you are more than anxiety. You keep asking the questions, and I'll keep answering them.